हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू डायमंड ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशन के सेट एंड नीट ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। आई होप यू आर ऑल आर रेगुलरली फॉलोज दिस ऑनलाइन क्लासेस बिकॉज ऑफ इट इज़ योर फ्यूचर स्टूडेंट्स। सो इफ यू प्रैक्टिस मोर देन ओनली यू गेट ए गुड रैंक इन के सेट एंड नीट। सो यू आर द रिस्पॉन्सिबल पर्सन फॉर योर ब्राइट फ्यूचर। ओके, सो टुडे I'm going to explain aldehydes and ketones and carboxylic acid. In yesterday class, we already completed alcohols, phenols and ether. So today, aldehyde, ketones and carboxylic acid is our concept. So here, first question, which of the following statement not true about C double bond O group? Okay, first try to understand the question. Which of the following statements not true? So this is underlined point, not true about a carbonyl group, C double bond O group. So here, first option, the carbon atom of the carbonyl group is sp2 hybridized carbon. So that is the correct statement, student, because of carbonyl group is nothing but C double bond O group. Okay, C double bond O group. So in this carbonyl group, the carbon hybridization is sp2 hybridization. And it has a planar structure. So therefore, this is the correct statement. A is a correct statement. Because of C double bond, in C double bond O, carbon hybridization is what? sp2 hybridization. So therefore, this is the correct statement. And second one, the C double bond O bond length. So this is the C double bond O. The bond length in between carbon and oxygen is longer than the bond length in between carbon and carbon. So that is the second statement. Okay, so see here, we already know atomic size of oxygen. For example, this is a oxygen atom. Atomic size of oxygen is smaller than the atomic size of carbon atom. Okay, so atomic size of oxygen is smaller than the atomic size of carbon atom. We already know, because of in a period from left to right, atomic size will be decreases. Therefore, these two elements present in a second period, therefore oxygen has a smaller atomic size. So if here oxygen has a smaller atomic size, therefore the bond length in between carbon and oxygen is very small when compared with carbon and carbon. Okay, so we already know here carbon and carbon, in between carbon and carbon, double bond is present, means sp2 hybridization. Therefore, the bond length in between these two carbons is 1.34 angstroms. But in carbonyl compounds, the bond length in between carbon and oxygen is 1.23 angstroms. That means what, student? Here C double bond O, in between carbon and oxygen, the bond length is very small when compared with carbon and carbon. Okay, but option is what? C double bond O bond length is longer. Therefore, this is a wrong statement. Actually, what, student? The bond length in between carbon and oxygen is very small than the carbon and carbon. What is the reason? Because of oxygen has a smaller atomic size. So therefore, your bond length is very less. Therefore, this is a wrong statement. Okay, so the question is what? Which of the following statements not true about C double bond O group? So this is a not a true statement, this is a wrong statement. And remaining third and fourth option, once you observe this, the dipole moment of aldehydes. Aldehyde means what, student? To this C double bond O, one side alkyl group, another side hydrogen. This is aldehyde. And to this C double bond O, both sides alkyl group, then it is ketone, and it is aldehyde. Aldehydes and ketones, those are more polarity because of high electron negativity of oxygen atom is present in aldehydes and in ketone. Due to the presence of more electron negativity of oxygen atom, they shows more polarity. But here ketones has more polarity than aldehyde because of two alkyl groups are present. These two alkyl groups are responsible for ketones are showing more polarity. Therefore, ketone dipole moment is more when compared with the aldehyde. So therefore, it is also correct statement. So A is correct statement, C also correct statement, and D, here the molecule carbonyl group has a planar structure, so that is also correct statement. Therefore, for this question, second option is wrong statement. So therefore, this is the answer. Next, so second question is, so this is compound, student, what is the name of this compound? Acetone or 2-propanone. So it containing ketone functional group. So this compound react with sodium cyanide and HCl. So this compound react with sodium cyanide and HCl. First it forms A. A is the intermediate. That intermediate undergoes hydrolysis. And produces B. So here, what are A and B? That is the question. So first try to understand the question. So this is acetone, student. Acetone react with sodium cyanide and HCl. They produces A, and after formation of this A, it is undergoes hydrolysis and it forms the B. Here, what is A and B? That is the question. Okay, so once you observe these four options, A, B, C, D, in these four options, so first A, B, C, D, so A compound is same in all these options, that is cyanohydrin, but B compounds are different, they are given different. So let us find out which one is the suitable answer for this question. See, student, this is acetone. So like the CH3, C double bond O, CH3, the compound name is acetone. We already know in ketone, oxygen has more electron negativity than the carbon. Therefore, what happens? The double bond is shift towards the oxygen side in ketone. Then this oxygen gets a negative charge and carbon gets a positive charge. So here sodium, from this sodium cyanide and HCl, finally it forms HCN, hydrogen cyanide. In sodium cyanide and HCl, finally they forms hydrogen cyanide. That is simple concept. So hydrogen cyanide, when it is undergoes decomposes, it forms H plus and CN minus. So this H plus go and attack to the O minus, and CN minus go and attack to the carbon plus. Then what happens? So CH3, there is no change in CH3, and to this carbon plus, here CN minus is addition. So here CN minus, and to this O minus, H plus is addition. So OH, it is converted to OH. So this is intermediate, student. It is intermediate, is nothing but A. Okay, it is nothing but a product. So what is the name of this compound? We already known cyanohydrin. So if the aldehydes are ketone, whatever it may be, if they react with hydrogen cyanide, they forms what? Cyanohydrin. Now this cyanohydrin, here A is cyanohydrin. Cyanohydrin undergoes hydrolysis. So we already known, if the cyanide group undergoes hydrolysis, that cyanide group is converted to carboxylic acid group. Okay, so that cyanide group is converted to carboxylic acid group. So this is a concept. So always if the cyanide undergoes hydrolysis, that cyanide group is converted to carboxylic acid. Therefore CH3CH3, there is no change, OH, and finally it forms a COOH. So that is a product, and this is a B product, student. Okay, so A is what here? Cyanohydrin, and B is what here? So the cyanide group is converted to carboxylic acid. So first option, so this is the cyanohydrin A, and second one, so two methyl group and carbon OH COOH, carbon OH COOH. Therefore, this is the correct option for second question. So next continuation question is Cannizzaro reaction. Okay, Cannizzaro reaction in aldehydes and ketones, Cannizzaro reaction. So here Cannizzaro reaction, they are given below like this. So here, this is the compound. Here, these two aldehyde groups, in the presence of base, one aldehyde group is converted into alcohol, another aldehyde group is converted into acid. Okay. So this is Cannizzaro reaction. The question is what, student? In this Cannizzaro reaction, which one is a slow step? Okay. So that is a question. Right. So here in Cannizzaro reaction, first I am given the statement for Cannizzaro reaction. Here the Cannizzaro reaction is nothing but aldehydes doesn't contain alpha hydrogen. Okay, aldehydes doesn't contain alpha hydrogen. In the presence of base, one aldehyde converted into carboxylic acid and one aldehyde converted into alcohol, that is named as a Cannizzaro reaction. Again, Cannizzaro reaction is aldehydes, this is aldehyde and this is alpha carbon. At this alpha carbon there is no hydrogen, and this is aldehyde, this is alpha carbon. At this alpha carbon there is no alpha hydrogen. So therefore aldehydes doesn't contain alpha hydrogen. In the presence of base, one aldehyde converted into alcohol, one aldehyde converted into carboxylic acid. It is called as a Cannizzaro reaction. Okay, so I'm going through mechanism for this Cannizzaro reaction. See students, this Cannizzaro reaction completed in three steps. So here this is the first step. In first step, once you observed the base, this is the compound, this is the reactant. So the base, OH minus is base. So the base here attack at this carbon, because of in this aldehyde oxygen is more electron negative, therefore the bond is shift towards oxygen side, and OH minus attack at this carbon. So therefore, because of here carbon gets positive charge. Okay, so this is the first step, and we get the product like this. Okay, OH minus attack at this carbon. Now carbon containing OH here, carbon already containing hydrogen, and this double bond were converted into O minus, and there is no change in aldehyde, there is no change in aldehyde. This is the first step. What is the first step? Attacking of hydroxide ion at carbonyl carbon. Attacking of hydroxide ion at carbon. So that is the first step. Next, second one, what student here? So again, so this aldehyde group is converted like this, and here negative charge is shifts in between the oxygen and carbon. Negative charge is shifts in between oxygen and carbon. Now at this carbon, electron density is increases. Because of this negative charge shifts in between carbon and oxygen, then hydrogen is eliminated as hydride ion. H minus is nothing but hydride ion. This hydride ion, it is going to attack to the another carbonyl carbon. Okay, that is the second step, student. Okay, that is the second step. First step is what? Attacking of hydroxide to the carbonyl carbon. Second step is what? Shifting of hydride shift to the another carbonyl carbon. So next, so if the hydride shift to here, this carbonyl carbon is converted like this. So here carbon containing two hydrogen, and this double bond oxygen is converted as O minus. Next, in third step, this hydrogen, because of this compound is converted like this carboxylic acid, and this hydrogen attack with this oxygen, then here this hydrogen is attacked with this oxygen and it is converted as a alcohol. So totally, and here what happens, student, in third step, the proton shifts from carboxylic acid to alcohol, to the alcohol side. So that is third step is called as a proton transfer. So totally it has three steps: hydroxide ion attacking to the carbonyl carbon, hydride shift to the another carbonyl carbon, and proton transfer. So finally we get this compound. The transfer of hydride to another carbonyl group. So this is a slow step, and in this reaction one aldehyde converted into carboxylic acid and another aldehyde converted into alcohol. So therefore it is called as a Cannizzaro reaction. In this Cannizzaro reaction, third step is slow step. Next one. So this question is related to third question, student. Next, in which of the following, which one is disproportionation reaction? So here they are given four options: aldol condensation, Cannizzaro reaction, benzoin condensation, and Itard reaction. In these four options, which one is called as a disproportionation reaction? Disproportionation reaction means what, student? 50% oxidation, 50% of oxidation and 50% of reduction takes place. Then that kind of reactions are called as a disproportionation reaction. So what is aldol condensation first? Two aldehydes containing at least one alpha hydrogen. So these are alpha hydrogens. Two aldehydes containing at least one alpha hydrogen in the presence of base, there forms a aldol product. Okay, they form a aldol product, that is called aldol condensation. And the second one, Cannizzaro reaction. Just now I am explaining the Cannizzaro reaction. Cannizzaro reaction, what, student? Here once you observe, this is formaldehyde. Formaldehyde. So aldehyde doesn't contain alpha hydrogen. So this is aldehyde and doesn't contain alpha hydrogen because of there is no alpha carbon. So therefore there is no alpha hydrogen. Therefore aldehyde doesn't contain alpha hydrogen. In the presence of base, one aldehyde undergoes oxidation and forms acid. We already know if aldehyde undergoes oxidation, forms acid. If aldehyde undergoes reduction, it forms alcohol. So therefore here 50% of oxidation, this is oxidation product. Okay, this is oxidation product. What is oxidation? Addition of oxygen. So to this carbon, add one oxygen, student. If we add one oxygen, then it is forms what? Carboxylic acid. And reduction means what? Addition of hydrogen or removing of oxygen. So therefore to this carbon, add to this oxygen, add one hydrogen, or to this carbon, add one hydrogen, and to this oxygen, add one hydrogen. So totally addition of two hydrogen, then it is called reduction. So it formed by the reduction, it is formed by the oxidation. Therefore here 50% of oxidation, 50% of reduction takes place. Then it is called as a Cannizzaro reaction, and it is also named as a disproportionation. Because of disproportion is nothing but what? 50% of oxidation and 50% of reduction. Therefore here Cannizzaro reaction undergoes disproportionation reaction. Remaining benzoin condensation and Ittard reaction already we know. Benzoin condensation is nothing but two moles of benzaldehyde in the presence of cyanide react with each other and form benzoin is product. And Ittard reaction is nothing but toluene react with chromyl chloride. So and it forms benzaldehyde. It is named as a Ittard reaction. But only in Cannizzaro reaction 50% of oxidation, 50% of reduction is occurs. That's why it is called disproportionation reaction. Is when propanoic acid is treated with sodium bicarbonate, it liberates the carbon dioxide. The question is what here? That carbon dioxide contains a carbon. That carbon came from what? That is the question. Okay, student. So first try to understand the question. Reactants are propanoic acid and sodium bicarbonate. So here propanoic acid react with sodium bicarbonate, then it liberate the carbon dioxide. So the question is, these carbon dioxide contain one carbon. That carbon comes from either from sodium bicarbonate or from propanoic acid or from methyl group or from methylene group. So that is the question, student. So for this question, the hint is, this is propanoic acid. So react with sodium bicarbonate. Actually sodium bicarbonate is NaHCO3, but for our convenient, this sodium bicarbonate is also written like this. Okay, Na plus O minus C double bond OH. It is also sodium bicarbonate. It is propanoic acid. We already know this is acid. Acid means what? It liberates the H plus. It liberates the H plus. Therefore H plus go and attack to this O minus from the sodium bicarbonate. Then it is converted to O minus and H plus OH group and C double bond O OH. Okay. And it is converted to CH3, CH2, C double bond O O minus addition with Na plus. Next. So this compound is converted like this and this is the converted like this. By the heating, here carbon dioxide is eliminated from this molecule, from this compound. So carbon dioxide in remaining H2O water is eliminated. Therefore the carbon dioxide is liberated in this reaction. This carbon dioxide is obtained from what, student? Sodium bicarbonate. Therefore option D is correct for this question. Next. So here, which one of the following orders of acid strength is correct? This is another question. So here the question, first try to understand the question. So they are given four kind of compound, student. One is carboxylic acid, alcohol, water, acetylene. So all are these acids. But question is what? Which one is strong acid? Which one is weak acid? That is the question. So first, acid means what, student? Acid means they liberate the proton H plus. Okay. So here first, for this question, this is the hint. Carboxylic acid liberate H plus ion, therefore acid. Water in dissociation it forms H plus acid. Alcohol in dissociation it forms H plus acid. Acetylene. Here acetylene is nothing but CH triple bond. CH is nothing but acetylene. In acetylene, carbon hybridization is sp. So in sp hybridization, s percentage is 50, p percentage is 50. So here, as the s percentage is increases, electron negativity also increases. Therefore, in acetylene, carbon sp hybridization, therefore s percentage is 50. So here s percentage is increases, therefore electron negativity also increases. If the electron negativity of carbon is more, then it attract electron from hydrogen and it is eliminated as H plus, therefore it is also acid. But all are acid, but the question is which one is strong acid. See student, carboxylic acid, after the formation of H plus ion, it forms carboxylate ion. This carboxylate ion is stable due to the participation of resonance. Okay, due to the participation of resonance, so therefore it is stable compound when compared with carboxylic acid. Therefore it is easily forms H plus ion or fastly forms H plus ion, therefore it is a strong acid. In all these compounds, carboxylic acid strong acid. Therefore option A, option B, option C, option D, in all these carboxylic acid is strong. Next one, water and alcohol. So in these two, water forms H plus ion, alcohol also forms H plus ion. But in alcohol, R group is present, alkyl group is present. So alkyl group is electron donating group. Electron donating group destabilizes the hydroxide ion. But in water, there is no that kind of electron donating group. Therefore, water is more acidic than the alcohol and least is acetylene. So therefore, carboxylic acid, next water, next alcohol, next acetylene. Therefore, B is the correct answer for this question. Next question here, which of the following compounds gives formic acid is a product on hydrolysis? So they give four options here: methyl chloride, dichloromethane, and chloroform, ethyl chloride. So in these four, which compound on hydrolysis it gives formic acid? That is the question. See student, this is chloroform and it is hint. Here chloroform CHCl3, when it is react with potassium hydroxide, 3 moles of potassium hydroxide. So here potassium hydroxide forms K plus and OH minus. So in chloroform, 3 chloride ions, they are substituted with 3 OH minus. So 3 chlorides, they are substituted with 3 OH minus, and these chlorides are eliminated with K plus ions as a KCl. So in this place of 3 chloride, here 3 OH groups are substituted. We already know if the OH groups are present on the same carbon, that is unstable product. Therefore elimination of water takes place, H2O, elimination of water takes place. Then remaining what? Hydrogen and carbon and OH group. So here this oxygen and form a double bond. So this is formic acid. Okay, so that formic acid is formed from what, student? Chloroform, by the hydrolysis. Okay, by the hydrolysis with KOH it forms formic acid. Therefore option C is correct. Next, consider the following reaction. So this is the reaction, student. What is the reactant? Silver Ag, silver salt of carboxylic acid, react with bromine. So then it forms alkyl bromide and silver bromide and carbon dioxide. These are the products. So this is the reaction. Question is what? This reaction is known as X. Okay, so this reaction is known as X, and this reaction proceeds via Y. Okay, proceeds through Y intermediate. Then the question is, what is the name of this reaction? And what kind of intermediate formation takes place in this reaction? So option HVZ, X is HVZ, Y is carbon ion. In B, X is Sandmeyer, Y is free radical. In C, X is Wolff-Fischner and Y is carbene ion. And in D, X is Hansdicker reaction and Y is free radical reaction. So these are the options. So this is a hint for this question, student. Hansdicker reaction. What is Hansdicker reaction? Silver salts of carboxylic acid react with bromine and they forms alkyl bromide. So that is a Hansdicker reaction. In this Hansdicker reaction, so if the reactant contains two carbon, then product contain only one carbon. That means carbon number is decreases, one carbon number is decreases in product. And reactant contain more number of carbon, one carbon is more than the product. Okay, that is Hansdicker reaction. Next, mechanism for this Hansdicker reaction. So first bromine, this Br2, it is undergoes homolytic cleavage. So if it is undergoes homolytic cleavage, they forms radicals, single electron species, free radicals. Now in second step, that in this one of the Br radical react with the silver salts of carboxylic acid, therefore AgBr formation takes place. And so here carboxylate free radical formation takes place. Again this intermediate undergoes homolytic cleavage, so therefore it forms carbon dioxide, CO2 and R radical. That R radical react with another Br radical, then it forms alkyl bromide. So finally forms alkyl bromide, student, and it is named as a Hansdicker reaction, and this reaction proceeds through free radical mechanism. Therefore option D is correct for this question. So here next question, dry ice react with A and forms 2,3 dimethyl butanoic acid. Okay, this is the reaction, student. Here 2,3 dimethyl butanoic acid is product and reactants are dry ice and A. The question is, what is A in this reaction? Okay, that is the question. So right, for this question the hint is, student, dry ice is nothing but carbon dioxide, CO2. Okay, CO2, carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide, CO2, this is the CO2. When carbon dioxide react with Grignard reagent, RMGX, see here, RMGX Grignard reagent, R forms minus MGX plus. And in carbon dioxide, oxygen is more electron negative, therefore there are double bond shift over on this oxygen. And now oxygen get negative charge, carbon get positive charge. From this Grignard reagent, alkyl group R minus go and attack to this carbon plus, then it forms R minus carbon plus RC. So double bond O and O minus attack with MgX plus, so therefore MgX. Okay, this is intermediate. And now this intermediate undergoes hydrolysis, react with water. So what happens again here, O minus and MgX, from the water it forms H plus and OH minus, therefore H plus addition to O minus and it is converted to carboxylic acid. Okay, and this is byproduct, MgXOH is a byproduct. Okay, finally it forms what, student? Carboxylic acid. This is the major concept. What is concept? Grignard reagent when react with carbon dioxide, it forms carboxylic acid. That is the concept. Therefore here dry ice react with A is what? Grignard reagent. Because of Grignard reagent, when it is react with carbon dioxide, what is the product? Carboxylic acid. Here in place of R, if methyl group is present, then here R plus methyl group, acetic acid formation takes place. So if in place of R, in Grignard reagent, in place of R, if ethyl group is present, then it is propanoic acid formation takes place, like that. So therefore finally it forms carboxylic acid. See, student, in carboxylic acid, this acid part is obtained from carbon dioxide and remaining this is alkyl part. Alkyl part is obtained from Grignard reagent. So here product is what? 2,3 dimethyl butanoic acid. So this is 2,3 dimethyl butanoic acid, 2,3 dimethyl butanoic acid. So this is the product. In this product, this part is obtained from carbon dioxide and this part is obtained from Grignard reagent. So therefore this is R part from the Grignard reagent. So R MgX like that. So therefore here A is what, student? This is A. So that means for this we have to add MgBr. Okay, so that is the concept. Therefore CH3 MgBr. B CH3 CHCH3 CHCH3 MgBr. So that is the answer for this question. Next, another question, the end product C. So in this reaction end product is C. So here C is what? That is the question, student. Option A, acetal oxime, formaldehyde oxime, methyl nitrite, acetal oxime. Okay, so these are the options. See here, acetic acid, when it is react with calcium carbonate, so here 2 moles of acetic acid, when they are react with calcium carbonate, we already known acid is nothing but they forms H plus ions. They forms H plus ion. So from these 2 acids, H plus and H plus, 2 hydrogens and 1 oxygen from carbon dioxide, they are eliminated as CO3-2, they are eliminated as water and carbon dioxide, and this calcium, it is linked in between these 2 oxygen, then it forms calcium diacetate. Okay, calcium diacetate. So this is A, student. In this reaction this is A, and that A undergoes heating. So if the A compound undergoes heating, it eliminates calcium carbonate, CaCOOO. Okay, 3 oxygen. So it is eliminated as calcium carbonate. Then remaining what? CH3, C11O, CH3. Ketone formation takes place, acetone. So that is B. Now this ketone react with hydroxylamine, NH2OH is named as a hydroxylamine. So if the ketone react with hydroxylamine, elimination of water, H2O, from hydroxylamine H2, and from ketone oxygen water is eliminated, and instead of oxygen here one NOH group is substitution, then we get CH3 C double bond NOH CH3. So this is the product and named as a acetoxime. Therefore option D correct for this question.